but it didn't really go with the stack because it's bright ass orange. Hello everybody, it's your girl Jay, and today I am here with a Christmas book tag that I saw over on Heather from Bookable's channel. It was originally created by Call Me After Coffee, so I will leave their link as well as Heather's down below for you guys to check out, but there are 8 questions total to answer, so without further ado, let us get started. The first prompt is Twinkling Lights, what is your most beautiful book? And I am going with The Nature of Witches by Rachel Griffin. I have talked about this book and how beautiful I think it is in pretty much every one of my videos since I received a copy of this book, but it's not this part I'm talking about. Like, this part is nice, sure, it's great, but when you take off the dust jacket, can we just? Hello, butterfly moment. I love butterflies. I hold them very near and dear to my heart. So I just think that this book is gorgeous and I just want to display it on my shelf for everybody to see and for me to stare at all day. I haven't even read this book. I don't even know if it's good, but it is beautiful, so I'll give it that. The next question is The Perfect Tree. Will you pay more price for a beautiful edition of a book? And I will not. I am super duper 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 cheap. I think it's been like over 4 years since I've bought a book at full price with like my own personal money. I am a huge believer in secondhand books. I would rather buy a book for $2 than $50. That's just my personal preference, but no, I don't feel the need to need special editions of books unless somebody wants to give them to me. You know? The next prompt is to build a snowman, and you are supposed to build a stack of Christmas books, either theme or color. Y'all thought I was gonna go with a red and green stack for Christmas, but no, I'm going for the blue and silvers because when I think Christmas, I think like snow, winter, blue, silver. You know? That's just me. I didn't want to be like everybody else because that's who I am as a person. I like to be unique and one of a kind. So I have Gods and Monsters by Shelby Mahern. This is the third book in the Serpent and Dove trilogy. Have I read it yet? No, but I really need to because I was obsessed with the first two books. And then I also have Winter Glass by Alexia Hillier. This is the second book to Spindle Fire, which I read a while ago. I think I read it in like 2017. So I really do need to read that. And then I have Dragon Republic by R.F. Kuang. This is the second book to Poppy War. Have I read the Poppy War yet? No, but it didn't really go with the stack because it's bright ass orange. And then the final one is Bloodleaf, and I don't even know who this is by, but I recently bought this on a trip to my boyfriend's house because we went to the mall and it was only $6, and I was sent the second book in the series a long time ago by the publisher, but I didn't have the first one. So $6 for a book? Yes, please. That brings us back to the perfect tree question. $6 is much better than $40. The fourth prompt is Crackling Fire. What is a book that makes you feel warm and cozy? I honestly don't even know. I don't know. I think I'm going to go with the entire Lunar Chronicles series. I think that was the first series that I really fell in love with all of the characters, and they just feel like a warm hug to me. Like, you know when you watch Frozen and you see Olaf and you're just like, oh, he is just a little warm hug. That's what I feel like the characters of the Lunar Chronicles are for me. I just want to be part of their group, honestly. The next prompt is knee-high socks, and that is, what is the longest book that you have read? I had to resort back to Goodreads to find the answer to this, and apparently it is Winter by Marissa Meyer. This is 827 pages, which I feel like is not that much, but that is apparently the longest book I've read, so I did give it a 5 out of 5 stars, so those 827 pages were worth it in the end because I love this series. So. Next is Ugly Sweaters, and it is, what is the ugliest book that you own? And I had to go searching for this because I could not think of a really ugly book, and I was looking for a completely different one, but then I stumbled across this, and I just, what is this? It's called Reset by Shane Barr. Don't know what it's about. It's hidden behind literally every single book I've ever owned because, who made this? That's what I want to know because as a cover designer, what were you thinking? Oh, it even comes with a bookmark of the same thing. It's signed though, so thank you, Shane Barr, but you really need to work on your cover designs. Is that mean? I'm sorry to whoever designed this, but it's not good. Next up is Blizzards, and this is a book that is either set in the winter or a book that gives you chills or has dark themes. So I went with My Dark Vanessa by Kate Elizabeth Russell because I'm sorry, but I don't really think that you can get darker than this book because, like, it ripped me to shreds. It is a lot. You need to be in the right mindset to read this book because you will get stabbed in the heart, it'll get twisted, and then it'll be pulled out and they will watch you bleed to death. So it has a lot of dark themes and it's a lot to read, but it's really good. I gave it 5 out of 5 stars. And then the final prompt is Home for the Holidays, and it is for the rereaders out there, and it is, what is a book that feels like coming home to you? I don't reread books, so I can't really say a book. I am going to say one, but I don't know if it really counts, but it is The Night Before Christmas because this is the one book that I reread every single year on Christmas Eve with my mom and my brother. We cuddle up into her big huge bed and we read this book together, and it's been a tradition of ours since I was like a baby. I think it's been as long as I can remember. So I'm 26 now and we still do this. So I think that this is the book that definitely reminds me the most of home because I love my family. All right, everybody. So that was the Cozy Christmas book tag. Like I said, I will leave the original creator and Heather from Bookables videos down below. You guys can check them out. I tag all of you who want to do this because it was a lot of fun. Let me know if you've read any of these books and what you thought of them, and I will see you all in my next video. Goodbye.